What is the most dangerous creature in the world?
The mosquito.
Nearly every minute, a child dies of malaria in Africa.
Because of malaria, we are losing so many great children. Some die, or they get sick and may not have time for their talents to be nurtured.
If you lose a child, you have lost a generation.
I've been a teacher for 15 years. This age group, it's so special. They are still very young. They are really very much ready to learn. Teaching really must be accompanied with some play and music. It makes the teaching to be enjoyable. Malaria has really impacted negatively on the lives of the pupils. Whenever these children are sick, they cannot make it to school. And this really makes them lose a lot academically. In a week, we may have 3 missing school. Whenever a child falls sick, it really worries me.
When I was 14 years, I got very sick and my parents decided to take me to hospital. And the results come that I was suffering from malaria. I felt so weak.
I was having headache, stomachache.
I was thinking I will die.
My parents took me to the hospital and they used a lot of money to treat me.
Missing school is bad. When I came back, I could not even get what the teacher taught in the past. I feel so sad.
One of our pupils lost her life. You could see it was malaria from the signs. It was serious. I don't want to lose any of my children to malaria again.
On average, a child could get malaria 2-3 times a year. The process of caring for the child does put a lot of stress on the household income, household productivity, the child's well-being, the child's education, and really has this pervasive impact at the household level, which can last for a very, very long time.
If we look at the impact of malaria, we tend to talk about child survival, but those who survive have lost something and they might not explore their potential.
Among the millions who are admitted each year, a good proportion of those who survive will develop lifelong consequences due to what we call severe malaria.
Severe malaria has really a lot of implication on the child's growth, on the child's mental state, and on the child's intelligence as a whole.
Some will get seizures, others will get cognitive challenges, and has significant impact on the overall child development.
So it's not a disease that's just an episode and gone. It's one that we need to be concerned about because it has far-reaching effects.
So children are unfortunately more affected. However, there is hope because there is treatments. There's what we call the seasonal malaria chemo prevention, which is given the children under the age of 5 in seasonal times when it's more rainy. And now there's the vaccines as well.
Let's not just talk about survival, but for the African child to have full potential in the future.
When I grow up, I would like to be an editor. Businesswoman,
journalist, doctor,
an engineer, because you'll work with be a millionaire.
For Kenya to be there in the future, we have to take care of these young children because they are the future generation.